Now we have to study the Thevenin's theorem. The statement of Thevenin's theorem is like that: any two terminal linear network containing a source of EMF and resistance can be replaced by equivalent circuit consisting of voltage source in series with a single resistance RTH. So this is the statement. So the statement is shown in this figure. Any two terminal linear network, this is the two terminal linear network, terminal A and terminal B. In this linear network there is one source and two resistance, and this is load resistance RL. According to this theorem, this can be replaced. Network containing source and EMF and resistance can be replaced by equivalent circuit, by equivalent single circuit consisting of voltage source in series with single resistance RTH. So this voltage source is in series with single resistance RTH, means if there are number of resistance are connected in series or whatever be the combination, we can replace this resistance by an equivalent resistance RTH, and this voltage source is connected in series with this RTH. So this is the only statement of Thevenin's theorem. Right? See again, any two terminal linear network, any two terminal linear network containing source of EMF and resistances, source of EMF and resistances can be replaced by equivalent circuit consisting of source in series with single resistance, means we can replace these two resistance with an equivalent resistance and called as RTH. The source should be connected in series with RTH. So this is the given network and this is Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Now we have to find out load resistance, the value of that equivalent resistance RTH, and current passing through that load resistance, it is RL. Now from figure R1 and RL, from figure R1 and R2 are parallel. Therefore, this equivalent resistance of this R1 and R2 is 1 by Rx is equal to, we know the formula for parallel combination. It is 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R1, 1 upon RL. So if we see this resistance R2 and RL, these are two resistance are in parallel. So by using this formula of parallel combination, we can replace this two resistance by equivalent resistance Rx, R2 and RL. Okay, RL should be there. Resistance R2 and RL are parallel combination, therefore their effective resistance is 1 by Rx is equal to 1 upon R2 plus 1 by RL. Therefore Rx is equal to R2 RL upon R2 plus RL. Now the resistance, instead of these two resistance R2 and RL, we can use the resistance Rx. Now this Rx, resistance Rx is in series with R1, therefore we can write, now resistance Rx and R1 are in series. Therefore, applying EMF is equal to the total potential difference is equal to potential difference across R1 plus potential difference across Rx. In last lecture we see this combination. If there are number of resistance connected in series, then total potential difference is equal to the potential difference developed across the given resistor. So by using this principle we can write total applied potential is equal to potential at across R1 plus potential across the effective resistance of this two. Therefore, we know the formula of potential difference, V is equal to I into R. Therefore, I into resistance R, it is R1. Similarly here, potential difference across Rx is equal to V, same formula, V is equal to I and R, but the value of R is, Rx is written over here. By using the value of Rx, what is the value of Rx? It is R2 RL divided by R2 plus RL. We can write R2 RL divided by R2 plus RL. Then, therefore, we can write here I is common. Therefore, if we take I outside, we can write R1 plus R2 RL divided by R2 RL. Is equal to, so by rearranging this term we can calculate capital I means current. What will be the current? Current is equal to I is equal to E upon this bracket. When we shift it towards the left, it will go to the denominator and formula will be I is equal to E upon R1 plus R2 RL. Plus sign is there. E upon R1 plus R2 RL divided by R2 plus RL. So this is the current I. So write the number of this equation. This is equation number 1. Now, R2 and RL are in parallel. The potential difference across R2 and RL must be same. What do you say? Resistance R2 and RL, these two resistances are parallel to each other. Hence, potential difference across these two resistances will be same. This is the common theory. If there are number of resistances which are parallel to each other, then potential difference across every parallel resistance is same. Okay, that's why we can write if R2 and RL are parallel, then potential difference across R1 R2 is equal to potential difference across RL. So what will be the potential difference across R2? Again, same formula. Potential difference V is equal to IR. So potential difference across resistance R2 is equal to I into R. But current passing through the resistance R2 is given over here. That current is I minus IL and R2. This is potential difference across R2. Formula: potential difference is equal to V is equal to I into R. R2 is the resistance, I is the current flowing through it. Similarly, potential difference across RL. Same formula. V is equal to I into R. Current flowing through this RL is I and resistance is RL. Therefore, potential difference is equal to I into RL. If we solve this, we multiply by R2, then it will become R2 I minus R2 IL is equal to I RL. Therefore, R2 I is equal to here we can write IL. If this term is shifted toward this side, it will become positive. R2 IL plus IL RL. Again, IL is appear in both the terms. Therefore, we can take it outside. Remaining term is R2 plus RL. We can take IL outside and formula will be R2 I is equal to R2 plus RL into IL. From this we can calculate IL is equal to, if we shift this term toward the right side, it will go to the denominator. And formula will be R2 I is equal to R2 plus RL. So this is equation number 2. Here we have determined I and IL. Now in equation 1, we have calculated I, right? In equation 1, we know the value of I. So if we put the value of I in this equation 2, value of I in equation 2, we will modify this IL by using the value of I in this equation. So we can write here in equation 1 and 2. Is in equation 1 in 2 we get IL is equal to, we have to put the value of I over this place, and formula will become R2 upon R2 plus R1, R2 upon R2 plus RL divided into I, means here E divided by R1 plus R2 RL divided by R2 plus RL. Therefore, E into R2, if you take multiply this product of numerator, it will become E R2 divided by this R1, R2 plus RL, R2 plus RL into. Now, here, if you take this E over here, then you can write only 1. Now, we have to multiply this R1 with this denominator, and then this value is added with R2 plus RL. Therefore, first product of this R2 plus RL into R1, R2 plus RL into R1, R2 plus RL into R1 plus this product R2 RL divided by, the denominator is R2 plus RL. Now, if we take product of this R1 plus R2, R1 plus RL, R2 plus RL divided by R1 plus R2 divided by RL, R1. So here what will happen? This R2 plus RL will get cancelled, and remaining term is E R2 divided by, take product of this R1, R2, R1, R2, R1 into RL, R1, RL plus R2, RL, R2, RL. Again, if you see this term, in both term RL is common, so you can consider RL is common and write this equation again. E R2 is equal to R1 R2 plus, if you take RL common, then remaining term is R1 plus R2, and here RL is the common. We are calculating IL. Therefore, this is IL, ER2 upon R1 R2 plus R1 plus R2 RL. Now, dividing the numerator and denominator of above equation. Dividing the numerator and denominator, of above equation by R1 plus R2. We get what we have to do, we have to divide the numerator and denominator by R1 plus R2. What we get? So E1 ER2 divided by R1 plus R2 divided by, here we are calculating IL, R1 R2 plus R1 plus R2 RL divided by R1 plus R2. I have to divide numerator and denominator with R1 plus R2. So this is the current passing through RL. So this value gives the current passing through RL represented by IL. This is equation number 3. After that, we have to calculate IL, means the current passing through Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Let us find VTH and RTH. To find out VTH, disconnect RL from the terminal A and B. So to find out VTH, so what we have to do? We have to find out VTH, means Thevenin's voltage. So for that we have to draw a diagram. This is source, resistance R1, resistance R2, this is terminal A and B. What we have done over here, we remove the load resistance from terminal A and B of the given circuit. Now the current passing through the resistance R2 is we are doing this for what? This is for to find VTH. Means we have to replace that source E with the source VTH. The VTH is what? The Thevenin's voltage. Instead of this E, we have to find out VTH. For that, we remove the load resistance across AB. Okay, so current passing through the resistance R2 is, we know the formula, I is equal to V by R. R is the total resistance. Now, the VTH between terminal A and B is VTH, voltage, Thevenin voltage between terminal A and B is, what will be the voltage? Formula voltage is, voltage is given by V is equal to I into R. So we have to find out the voltage over here. So it is VOC, output voltage is equal to, or VOC, or it is also called VTH. VTH is equal to, formula, we know that it is I into R, open circuit voltage. So the resistance over here, it is R2, and current passing through is I, therefore voltage is equal to I R2. Therefore, VTH is equal to E R2 upon R1 plus R2. So this is Thevenin's voltage, E R2 upon R1 plus R2. Here R2, as it is I, we know the formula of I. What is the formula of I? You can write over here. Current into resistance is equal to E. Therefore, E is equal to, sorry, I is equal to E upon R. The total resistance is R1 plus R2. Therefore, I is equal to E upon R1 plus R2. So this I, is replaced by E upon R1 plus R2, and this R2 is as it is. Okay, so this is VTH. Now we have, here we find VTH. Now we have to find out RTH, means equivalent Thevenin's equivalent resistance. Next step is what? Find out RTH. Now to find RTH, remove the battery from the circuit. And replace it by internal resistance. So from this circuit we have to remove this battery, then we will find equivalent resistance or RTH. So by replacing this battery, we can draw the diagram like this. This is only two resistors, there is only two resistors, battery is removed. The circuit will be like this. This is terminal A, terminal B, R1, R2. Here will be RTH. Now, these two resistors R1 and R2 are parallel. R1 and R2 are parallel. Therefore, their equivalent resistance is, we know the formula for equivalent resistance. If there are two resistors in parallel, then the equivalent resistance formula is R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. So this is the what equivalent resistance or Thevenin's resistance R2. This is equation number 4. Now this is equation number 5. Here we have calculated Thevenin's voltage, or here RTH is Thevenin's resistance, means equivalent resistance. Now the circuit consisting of VTH and RTH in series is called Thevenin's equivalent circuit, which we have already drawn in this figure, previous figure. Therefore, the current passing through RL of Thevenin's circuit can be calculated. Now, current passing through Thevenin's equivalent circuit is, the formula is current is equal to voltage upon resistance. So substituting this equation 4 and 5, in equation 4 I have calculated VTH, and equation 5 I have calculated RTH. So by using this VTH and RTH, this value and this value, our equation becomes IL is equal to therefore using equation 4 and 5, we get 4, in equation 4 we will get the value of VTH, and equation 5 we will get the value of RTH. Therefore final equation will be IL is equal to VTH, means we can write E R2 upon R1 plus R2 divided by IL is equal to, this is VTH upon RTH. RTH, what is RTH? It is R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 RTH plus plus sign as it is, and this is RL. So this is the current passing through IL of Thevenin equivalent circuit. So write this equation number 6. So equation 5 and 6 gives the current passing through the equivalent circuit. And equation 5 is the equivalent resistance. Okay, so this is the derivation for Thevenin's theorem.